Hey, happy Saturday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I know I don't upload on Saturdays because that is Sabbath, but we literally have lives at risk for today. Matter of fact, another potential tornado outbreak is going to happen for today. If you've seen Ryan Hall's stream yesterday, and I give him a lot of credit, he did a great job yesterday, saved a lot of lives potentially because we had a crazy night of tornadoes. Now, they have upscaled it again for today. We have a moderate section. We have chances not only for significant hail, at least 2 inches in diameter. We also have chances for hurricane force winds as this goes through the afternoon. And we still have the chances for significant tornadoes, EF2 or greater strength. So we really have another big day of storms that's going to happen all night long. And then again for Sunday, we have more coming. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I do weather forecasting all year long. Now I'm going to hurry up and get through this so you can see exactly what is going on for today so you know what to expect. As soon as the live streams get started, which is a great thing, they help a lot of people, this video is going to get killed like every other video, which is a good thing. The live streamers are saving a lot of lives. So God bless all of you that support the streamers. They do a great job. Now I'm going to show you this in just a moment, but there's some information you need to see. Now yesterday we had a bunch of reports. Matter of fact, we had 100 tornado reports. A lot of this was recycled. We had very strong tornadoes coming through Nebraska, through Iowa, through northern Missouri. It was a crazy amount of storms for yesterday. Now this is a wild shot of the tornado that hit Nebraska. This was a huge tornado. And this is a shot of the tornado a little west of Waverly. There was multiple tornadoes and strong tornadoes for yesterday. Here's another shot of a tornado that hit in Iowa yesterday. Look at the size of that tornado. Just look at the size of it. Very big and very worrisome. Here's another one that hit by Harlan, Iowa. And you're talking about multiple vortices inside this vortex. A huge monster tornado. Now, unfortunately, there was a lot of damage also. This shot was taken in Iowa. Remember, these links are in the description below to go watch the full video. Also on my X account, I did repost them for you. Because you can literally see there's nothing left to this house but the front door. Now, the great news is, besides all these destructions, because unfortunately, a lot of people are homeless going through what happened here, obviously. But the grateful thing that we have for today, unfortunately, look at this, is so devastating. The grateful thing we have for today is zero lives was lost in yesterday's outbreak. This is why they tell you to go to the lowest level floor of your house. This right here would not do. So here's your cities at risk for today, but your biggest threat is going to be right here for Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, going into Missouri. This is your hatched area. At least EF2 or stronger tornadoes expected. I'm seeing a couple of strong tornado trails potentially for today. Here's your cities and states at risk for the tornadoes for today. You also got the wind threat and the hurricane force winds expected, at least 74 miles per hour winds. Here's your cities and states at risk for the damage and winds for today. Also your hail threat. This big area is expecting at least 2 inches in diameter, probably over 2, maybe even 3 or bigger. Bigger than baseballs. Here's your cities and states at risk for the hail threat for today. National Weather Service put it as numerous severe thunderstorms are likely today and tonight across the southern and central plains into the lower to mid-Missouri Valley. The greatest potential for severe storms will be from North Texas into Oklahoma and southeast Kansas, where strong tornadoes, very large hail, over 2 inches in diameter, and widespread damage and winds, some over 70 miles per hour, are expected to occur. A broader area of severe threat will extend from south central Texas north northeastward to the Great Lakes. A tornado outbreak is expected today from North Texas into Oklahoma, southeast Kansas, and far southwest Missouri. So real quick, so we can go to the radar so you can see the timing on these storms. You can see our dew points are going to be there all day long. It's really going to spark up as we go 2-3 o'clock in the afternoon, and it's going to go all night long. The storms are going to be there till early in the morning. Now, when you look with your cape, with your lift, you do have a lot of lift, and it really builds up from 2 o'clock all the way to 5 and 6 o'clock. Very strong lift. But you notice after it gets about 8 and 9 o'clock, It's going to start losing its lift on the northern side of those storms. And as you go a little bit further towards 11 o'clock, it's really going to dissipate any lift that's in the atmosphere. But also can see that once you get around 4 and 5 o'clock, that you have potential strong lift in the lower level atmospheres. This will help give you rotation with height while you already have a lot of convection, and it does strengthen for eastern Kansas as you go towards 7 o'clock. Now, we do have cells coming through that area at that time, and that could strengthen as that goes through Kansas, and that is a potential. Even though you're running out of Cape, you're running out of lift, these lower level winds, strong winds, will keep your convection going. Also, they get stronger as you go through later in the evening for eastern Kansas, going through Oklahoma and northern Texas. And at that time, we have a nice line of storms with embedded cells in there passing through. Easily could spin up another threat out of that. Then it quickly dissipates as you go by early in the morning. So we really have a chance later in the evening where we have strong winds aloft, and it will keep these storms growing. Chances for damage and winds also. You see the bowing out feature in this whole line of storms. This is 3 a.m. in the morning. So you do need to watch out for these storm cells. You see how it travels all the way to the north. You lose the instability, but right here you have your winds aloft. And that's why it's still showing strength on those as that keeps growing through the night, through the early morning hours. You have strong winds aloft keeping those storms going. Then as you go for tomorrow morning, it's going to congeal right back up with your daytime heating and bring more storms towards the south. And you can see this when you look at your significant tornado perimeters. You get a lot of perimeters building up for Kansas going towards northern Missouri. Then once you hit around 8 or 9 o'clock, that starts dissipating, a chance for that to turn into a tornado. And it really grows for the area that's getting sheared with all them lower level winds, keeping them very strong all the way till 9 o'clock, all the way till 10 o'clock. Chances for tornadoes for Oklahoma, for Texas, as you go through 11 and 12 o'clock. Then it starts dissipating. But you still have chances with them lower level winds later in the evening because of those winds. Now, latest update with HRRR is showing widespread 40 and 50 miles per hour wind gusts. But it is showing that that cell for eastern Kansas, that will move around a little bit. It just shows that atmosphere is very ripe right there. Chances for 70, maybe even for something to get towards 70 or 80 for a moment. Strong cells coming from Kansas as you go through the evening. That's that one I was showing you. And you see the rest of the evening, high 50s on those as well. A big area for damaging winds that's going to be coming with this system is going to bring a lot of flooding as well. Potential some power outages coming out with this. Latest update, don't go that far. It's just 15-minute increments. But once again, it is showing that strong cell with strong damaging winds potential for eastern Kansas. Getting towards 70 and 80 once again. See how it moved around a little bit. It's just saying that this area right here is primed for that. It's going to be another strong night. And you can see this when you look at your hail threat. So as you start through the evening, once you get around 2 and 3 o'clock, it's going to start for Oklahoma. You're going to get a strong storm cell bringing a potential strong tornado. And it's dropping a lot of large hail with this as that tracks a potential long track tornado going through Oklahoma, maybe recycling again, going through Kansas. But you also have it coming through Colorado, through Nebraska, going to northern Missouri. Now, after 4 p.m., it looks like you get another chance for another strong tornado. Not only the multiple cells strengthening over Kansas, this is where your surface low really builds and spins. Northern Missouri goes into, unfortunately, southern Iowa again as you go towards 6 and 7 o'clock. Then you get more building for Texas, for northern Texas, going to Oklahoma. Then the line goes further down Texas the later you go in the evening, and it just builds up chances for large hail all the way to 8 o'clock in the morning for Sunday. Look at these three areas of strong trails going from Texas to Oklahoma, Oklahoma to Kansas, some of Kansas going into Missouri, and Missouri going into Iowa. Also have some of these popping up for Nebraska. It looks like a very strong night. This looks stronger for hail signatures than what we had for yesterday. So let's go into this a little bit and see what the timing is. You can see the time and date is up here on the top. This is central time as well, same as y'all. Now you get a lot of storms building up once you go around noontime. Texas lower, Texas is going to be a little bit later. But you see these do have a lot of strong hail cores with them as this comes through the evening as you go all the way to 1 and 2 o'clock. Now once you go towards 2 and 3 o'clock, this is where it's going to start growing. This is all the way till 4. You are still getting potentially a foot, a little over a foot for Colorado. But you can see how these storm cells come through all evening long. They start building up for Kansas. They're going through Missouri, southern Iowa, coming in from Oklahoma, going into Kansas. Now, this is by 8 o'clock tonight. Yeah, these storms brewing. Now you still have them by 9 o'clock. So now you're looking over here going from Iowa, going into Illinois. You see the hail cores in there. Northern Missouri as well. You can see them here for eastern Kansas and Oklahoma. A lot of strong cells popping up. Potentially bringing a lot of large hail with those. You're even getting a black inside the core. And that is showing chances for large hail when you have that. Now that's only till 9 o'clock tonight. And we already got this nasty line of storms going through southern Wisconsin, going through Michigan, some for northern Indiana as well. Don't worry, Indiana, it's not going to be a tornado. It's just some thunderstorms passing by. Now, once you go all the way till 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock, we still have that trail going through southern Wisconsin and Michigan. But now it's going further down into Texas now. But you can see these storms are going into northern Illinois. They're going from Kansas into Missouri, still staying nice and strong. This is where the northern half of these storms are going to start losing their instability. It's just going to be regular thunderstorms passing by, but then they're still bringing damage and winds with them as well, but it's going to lose its tornadic chances. But it's growing in the south because you have them lower level winds aloft. So you can see here for 11 o'clock for eastern Kansas, still got strong hail cores. You can see it here for Oklahoma, a lot of multiple strong hail cores. Each one of these is a different storm cell going all the way into northern Texas now. And this is where it starts stretching down and bring some damage and winds into Texas as well. So this is by 11 o'clock. Now we're moving towards 11:30, 11:45. And you can see how you got the bad storms over here by 9 o'clock all the way up towards Iowa. But once you hit around 10 and 11 o'clock, now you're losing a lot of the instability up here. Bring a little bit of hail cores into Illinois, not a whole bunch. But you still got the strong winds aloft down here in the south. So here it is for 11 o'clock. It's starting to stabilize up here on the north side. You see there's a hail core going through Illinois. That is going to be losing its strength. But you see here from Missouri, it's starting to just become regular thunderstorms. A little bit of hail still coming through, but it's still stronger down here for Kansas, Oklahoma. Look, multiple cells. Look at that. Northern Texas, still strong because of the winds aloft, chances for tornadoes. Now, once you go to midnight, now you can see right here, 1230, 1245. Now you have damaging winds coming through, but now you're losing the hail cores. You're losing all your instability. You still got the winds aloft down here in the south. Now they are starting to push through Oklahoma, and by 11 o'clock, you have a lot of nasty hail cores passing through, but it looks like it starts dissipating once you hit after 12. So you are at 12 o'clock, you still got hail cores, but now you got the damaging winds starting to push through, and you can see how everything changes once you go past midnight. Start losing your hail cores. It still becomes a damaging wind event. See the damaging wind still push through there, but you're losing your hail cores of that. This is 2 o'clock in the morning, and you still got storms coming through northern Illinois, going into Michigan. Still got them coming through Missouri with some damaging winds, through Kansas, Oklahoma, through Texas, with some damaging winds pushing behind that all morning long. And then for Sunday morning, this is where it brews right back up for Sunday. And we got another threat once again where all this builds up. Your chances for these storms with chances for hail and damage and winds as well. Not as strong as today. Today is going to be a very powerful day. Thank you for your time today, everybody. Hope all of you will be safe today. Please, I hope you are alerting your neighbors. You are alerting your enemies. Alerting everyone that you could to help them get prepared for these storms. This is not hype. I don't do hype. This is going to be a very serious day. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And before y'all go on with y'all day, a little words from our Father. Psalm 60, 1 through 5. O God, thou hast cast us off. Thou hast scattered us. Thou hast been displeased. O turn thyself to us again. Thou hast made the earth to tremble. Thou hast broken it. Heal the breaches thereof, for it shaketh. Thou hast showed thy people hard things. Thou hast made us to drink the wine of astonishment. Thou hast given a banner to them that fear thee, that it may be displayed because of the truth, Selah, that thy beloved may be delivered. Save with thy right hand and hear me. Amen. I wish the best for every single one of y'all out there. God bless you and keep you safe. And I do pray for every single body. Please stay off the roads today. Take this storm very seriously for today. and I appreciate every single one of y'all. Now, even though we have our little weather wars inside the communities, inside this YouTube, I know how it can be. It's to a lot of people, this is business, and business can be rough when other people are saying or doing the same things as you. But I do support a lot of people here on YouTube. I do support Ryan Hall's live streams. So if you haven't heard of him, I don't know what rock you've been living under, but look him up and go to his live stream. He has a team of people that will keep you safe today during these storms. I appreciate everybody for tuning into my video. And remember, all glory always goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Keep them safe, Father. For we do love you so much. Amen.